What's up YouTube, Biz Math here. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to talk about how I can't find a cash buyer for a recent wholesale real estate deal. Before we go on, you all be sure to smash that like button. It really supports this channel. And then comment down below on what you do when you can't find a cash buyer for your deals. And have you all dealt with that before in the past? Let me know your stories down below in the comments. And then subscribe if you're not subscribed. Also, you all check the different links in the description down below. You know, I have different tools and resources and an online course that you all can use in your wholesaling real estate journey. So why can't I find a cash buyer for this deal? So number one, let me just say, I do believe we will find a cash buyer for this deal because I am kind of mentoring a friend right now in this business, and he helped me get this lead. I'm kind of just showing him. We've been on a few appointments together and different things like that. We just got this property under contract 2 weeks ago, so we still have enough time to find a cash buyer for this deal. The number one issue blocking, I guess, our cash buyers from getting this property is that its roof is in shambles. So it has different holes in the roof, and then basically the top half of the house has to be replaced, like the roof, because there's moisture damage from it raining and then going on woods and going on different rooms and different stuff like that. The main house doesn't leak so much, like the kitchen, the living rooms, or the bedrooms, but certain parts like the bathroom, another room. Dealing with the roof, you probably have to restructure like a wall or two and different things like that. And so that's a huge issue for an investor when they take on a project like that, because that's a huge project. So I totally understand where my cash buyers are coming from. I would say the second reason why we probably can't find a cash buyer at our price point at the moment is because the property is currently in a flood zone. So being in a flood zone, that will require a cash buyer to usually buy insurance for a rental, or having the retail buyer get insurance once the property is flipped. The thing is, with it being in the flood zone, it's right on the edge, so it never floods in the house. Some parts of the backyard, it may puddle. That's what the seller was telling me. However, still an issue that needs to be addressed. And so a little bit of the details, I guess, about the property. I mean, we do have it at a low enough price where we can still wholesale it. We made enough spread on it, I guess, put it under contract at a good price where we can lower the price a little bit and play around with it a little bit. So I'm pretty sure we will find a cash buyer for this deal. It just may take a little bit longer. And you know, that's what happens in this business, you all. Sometimes you do get a deal and you can find a cash buyer that same day like that. And then some cash buyers, you know, it may take a month. It may take, you know, close to the closing date of that contract to find a buyer. And so even now, after I've done so many deals, you know, I still have to deal with that sometimes. And even big wholesalers have to deal with, you know, sometimes holding on to a property a little bit longer than what they expected. So you're probably thinking, all right, Matthew, you can't find a buyer. I can relate. What can I do about it? What are you going to do about it? So I already actually started working into finding new cash buyers around that area. And what I'm using PropStream. Link down below if you all are interested in a free 7-day trial, and you get a slight discount using my link. So if you're interested in PropStream, that the software I'm about to show you all right now on how I'm gonna find a cash buyer for this deal, link down below. All right, let's get right into it. Here in PropStream, and what I'm going to do, I'm just going to type in this city that this house is in, and I already have it probably uploaded right here. And it's in this area near Chattanooga, Tennessee, called Soddy Daisy. So if people who I know around the area, they probably already seen this deal and they know what I'm doing. But yeah, so it's in Soddy Daisy, Tennessee. And then what I'm going to do, I'm just gonna look at the comps a little bit, see there's 14,000 houses around the area, and we're just going to go straight to find our best cash buyers. Yes, they do have an already filtered cash buyers box option, but we're going to drill in even more so we can find the most motivation. So what I'm going to do, I'm gonna go down here to filter, and then I'm going to go to non-owner occupied, because I don't want this property to be an owner occupied property, right? I wanted it to be a property that an investor bought, but they don't live in it, right? Because they're either flipping it or using it as a rental, okay? And then the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to go over to ownership information, right? And I want to have the max year of ownership for 1 year, because I want to find recent cash sales within the past year. All right, so remember, we were around 14,000, and so now we're already down to 289 properties, right? And we still haven't put the filter in into buying this at 100% cash. So what are you going to do? You're going to go to valuation and equity, and for estimated equity, I'm just going to put the minimum at 99%. So right here, these are our criteria: non-owner occupied, 1 year of ownership or less, 99% or more equity. So basically cash sales that happened within the past year by investors. And we have a list of about 152 properties, right? So this is pretty amazing. So for example, I can look at this property right here. Like, this is obviously a flip property that an investor has, and it's probably on the market. And so what I'm going to do, just gonna kind of look through the pictures, make sure it's flipped. You know, I can tell by the you know, just the pictures. The door is new. If we go more inside the house, let's look inside. Okay, obviously, yeah, this is a flip property. And even I like looking at this. Okay, so this is their mailing address, and this is the address of the property. And then I like to look at linked properties. This person owns 12 properties around the area. So obviously, this person is a cash buyer that I can target, that I can cold call or send a text message to. And that's what I plan on doing. That's how I find cash buyers. If originally I blast out my original cash buyers list, I say, okay, I need to pull a new list and look for new cash buyers, and specifically in this area, right? So that's what I do. So I'm just going to pull this list, but next you have to skip trace this list because you have to get the phone numbers to either text them or cold call them. And so, you know, I already have this thing saved. So on PropStream, all you have to do is, once you have that list on my property, so for example, I have it right here. And then what are you going to do? You can just go to skip tracing right here, select contacts, and then you go to the group that you want, and then you add selected contacts, and then you click done, and then you click next. You can get the phones and emails, or just emails only, or just the phones. And then you pay for it. Obviously they show the price, it's 30 cents. I know it's a little bit more expensive as opposed to other places, but if you want everything here, you can. And then after you're done, where it shows up on your contacts. So when you go to contacts, they have this line under here called skip tracing, and then you just go over to Saudi Daisy Cash. You go here and then you can pull this list, and as you all can see, they have their phone numbers, they have the addresses, they have emails and different things like that. And yeah, that's essentially how, that's one way I will find my cash buyers for this deal. I'm going to cold call this list within the next day or two, and I'm going to text message them to see what they say. And I already started texting them, and I already got some responses. So I'm going to call them later today just to check up on them. All right, you all. So the next thing you can do to find cash buyers is actually wholesale with another wholesaler in town. So what I am going to do, I'm going to go to our real estate group around our area. I'm just going to look down the list to see if I find people posting wholesale deals. So I'm just going to scroll down just like this. This person is looking for houses. Someone's looking, I'm looking to purchase my second. So these are cash buyers also that you can target, and different things like that. I'm looking to purchase multifamilies. And then here, so we have somebody right here. They have a property that they're looking to sell, and they even have a whole website. And so what I would do, I would just PM this person and just see what they are, if they're actually like a wholesaler, and if they do joint ventures, and a joint venture with them to see if they have a larger cash buyers list than me, and just JV the deal, you know, split it three ways, since I am joint venture with another friend with this deal. So it's joint venture, a joint venture. All right, you all. So that's essentially my two main ways I'm going to find a cash buyer for this deal. And I'll keep you all updated on this very exact deal. Hopefully we can have a very great video just with my friend getting his first wholesale deal and just closing on this deal. And if not, I'm going to share that also, you know, if we have to cancel out of this deal, or if we have to do something. But you know, we created great rapport with the seller, but we'll see what happens, you all. Not gonna promise anything, but Yeah, you all, I understand, like, it can be frustrating when you can't find a buyer, especially if it's your first deal, you're worried, you're stressed. You know, I'm past those stages anymore. Like, if it goes a week or two without finding a cash buyer, I'm fine because I know if it's a deal, I'm gonna find a cash buyer. Another thing about this deal is that we showed 4 cash buyers already this property and all 4 of them said no. You know, the first person just said no. The second person, they kind of gave me offer. I came back with them seeing what else they can do, but they just flat out told me no. You know, they're not interested in a project like this. The third person said they found another house, probably doesn't have as many issues. And then the fourth person was like, you know, just the layout of this house is just more expensive than what I would thought it would be and different things like that. So I got to know what my cash buyers were thinking. And I actually asked the cash buyer, okay, how much do you think it would cost repairing the roof and fixing that? He was telling me like up to $25,000 just for the roof. Like it wasn't like a simple fix that you can pay like 10 grand or something. That's the dealio with this deal. I'll keep you all updated. And I hope you all really enjoyed this video. Be sure to like it once again. Comment down below, subscribe, and then I'll talk to you all later.